It's so stupid, it's positively brilliant. The Brilliant Podcast.
Trump, yes. Did you see what Trump said about Meghan Markle said?
What did he say? I missed it.
Ooh, this was it. So they asked Meghan Markle and Harry about who they were supporting for the election for some fucking reason. Why? Mm-hmm. I don't know. Who gives a fuck what Harry has to say about the election? And they said Biden. And then someone said at the Trump press conference, you got it, Al? You got the clip? It's all good.
I didn't hear
you. You got it? So they asked him, they said, what do you think about Harry and Meghan Markle saying they support Biden in the coming election? And then he says this. You got it, Taylor.
Prince Harry and Meghan Markle chimed in on the U.S. election and essentially encouraged people to vote for Joe Biden. I want to get your reaction to that.
I'm not a fan of hers. And I would say this, and she probably has heard that, but I wish a lot of luck to Harry. She's gonna need it.
We've never had a more consistent president.
Interesting.
You've never had a more consistent president. Trump is gonna give you exactly what you expect to get from Donald Trump. Trump, I'm telling you, there's only one other person, and I've said this before, there's only one other human that I know who was everything they advertised him to be, over exceeded expectations.
Gucci man.
LeBron James.
Oh, LeBron, yeah.
LeBron is the only person
that from the beginning,
they told us this is the guy,
and he
over exceeded expectations.
Yeah.
They told us what Trump was,
and
he's over exceeded expectations. It's actually amazing to watch. And he's not leaving the White House.
So do you think he's not leaving because he's going to lose and just not go, he's going to dispute the result?
It's a whole thing that I haven't downloaded enough to explain yet, but there's so many great articles on it, but it has to do with the Electoral College. You know what? Matter of fact, let me pull it up.
What is it about?
Hold on, I can read it in 2 seconds. Hold on. This article is in The Independent, and it's by a dude named Tim Wirth. He actually wrote this in July, but I've been reading so many of these for the past year. But Trump has a plan to stay in the White House if he loses the election, right? Now, Senator Tim Wirth says, he goes, there's a strategy to suppress voter turnout by purging voters, especially inner city voters, from registration rolls and to suppressing mail-in voting. He also believes physical polling locations will be limited, especially in urban areas, in an effort to create long lines on election day and discourage voting. His theory doesn't end at the ballot box. He believes that should the president lose, he will claim the vote was rigged and rely on a complicated gambit involving emergency powers and the compliance of Republican legislators to stay in the White House. According to Mr. Wirth, should Mr. Trump lose in a scenario where Joe Biden beats him by decent but not overwhelming margins in the swing states of Arizona, Wisconsin, Michigan and Pennsylvania, Mr. Trump would declare that the vote was rigged. He would supposedly blame mail-in ballots and Chinese election interference for the loss and invoke emergency powers to launch a Justice Department investigation into alleged election hacking in the swing states. From there, Mr. Wirth claims Mr. Trump will stall until December 14th, which is the date when states must appoint their U.S. Electoral College electors. Because the swing states are each controlled by Republicans, Mr. Wirth believes the state legislators will refuse to certify their elections until their electors until the election hacking investigation is finished. He then claims Democrats will challenge the investigation and the challenge to the election, which will eventually be taken to the Supreme Court. Mr. Wirth believes the Supreme Court will rule against the Republicans, but will concede that Mr. Trump's emergency powers authorize him to continue his investigation. The Supreme Court will also maintain that should the swing states not be able to certify their electors by December 14th for any reason, then the Electoral College will have to meet and vote for the president without the swing states included. Under Mr. Wirth's theory, the Electoral College will then meet without the swing states under the investigation.
And then they'll elect him.
And neither candidate will receive enough votes to secure the presidency. And then the House of Representatives, it'll move to the House of Representatives, where each delegation gets to cast one vote towards the presidency. Since they are more Republican-controlled House delegations than Democratic-controlled delegations, Republicans will win 26-23. Republicans will be the victors of the vote, and Mr. Trump will remain in office. Now,
wow,
that theory might sound crazy to some, not to Rafiki. Okay? I am expecting the goddamn series finale, our season finale. I don't know which one. The series finale, season finale 2020 is going to be something special. If you think this shit is ending on November 3rd and just regular, everybody go vote, you're out of your fucking mind. Uh-huh. And you haven't been paying attention and you don't know that guy. Same shit he said to Meghan Markle, he's going to say to America. He's going to say the exact same thing. I'm wishing you good luck because you're going to fucking need it. I'm telling you that right now.